Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We had some clustering of stronger seismic events. If you look at the SGI graph, that was on the 18th and 19th around the planetary conjunction Mercury, Sun and Neptune. This is marked by the red peak. It peaked magnitude 6.6 deep below Fiji. And as you can see, this is magnitude 5.6 and greater. We also see on the SGI graph that we have a convergence of critical planetary geometry on the 21st, 22nd, that's today, actually tonight and tomorrow morning. I already discussed that in the previous update and I will go into this in more detail. If we look at the solar system, we see that on the 18th we had the Mercury-Sun-Neptune conjunction and some stronger seismic activity. We see that tonight at 21:45 UTC, we have Sun, Venus and Uranus in a 90 degree angle. That's a heliocentric alignment. And several hours later, early on the 22nd at 4:34 UTC, Venus, Mercury and Jupiter also in a 90 degree angle. And that is a Venus-centric alignment. And then several hours later, we have at 10:56 UTC tomorrow morning, Sun, Venus, Mars in a conjunction. And that is a critical one. When Venus is in a conjunction with an outer planet, we can have a major seismic event around the time or just following that conjunction. So we have a clear convergence of critical planetary geometry here. And there is an additional factor that I have not yet addressed. And that is the close conjunction. It's not an exact conjunction, but a near conjunction with Earth, Mercury and Uranus. And that was closest yesterday night around 1800 UTC at 2 minutes 14 minutes. It doesn't come closer than that. But if you look at the animation here that I prepared, we see that both planets move in the same direction. Mercury slightly ahead and slightly faster, and Earth also. And that's why they never reach an exact conjunction with Uranus. But it is close and it may be an attributing factor in the whole of the planetary convergence that we have on the 21st, 22nd. So that actually comes on top. And how critical exactly that is going to be, I do not know. Again, it is not an exact conjunction. It doesn't get exact, but it certainly is very close and may be of significant influence. So what seismic activity can we expect in the coming days? It's difficult to say. It may stay in the 6 magnitude range, it may reach magnitude 7, and in the worst case scenario, maybe even magnitude 8. A seismic increase may already happen later today as we approach the critical planetary geometry. I'd say around the 22nd, this would match the atmospheric fluctuations that we picked up. Speaking of which, we had fluctuations on the 17th, and they all marked the regions along the west coast of North America, Cascadia subduction zone, Vancouver Island, but a seismic increase may occur to the north, south Alaska, also to the south California potentially. And also to the, near New Zealand, we have regions marked also on the 17th. And on top of that, yesterday night there were additional fluctuations marking the same regions, again, the west coast of North America and close to New Zealand. These regions could potentially see larger seismic activity. It is a rough estimate and is not always exact. It is an indication. This is the information that we have. Be on watch in the coming days. There could be major to great seismic activity in the worst case scenario. Stay safe. Until next time.